An hour in, and the giraffe convoy is almost out of the concrete jungle.
We're just on the outskirts of Sydney now, which is good because it's going to get a little easier from here. We're just trying not to jerk the truck around and make the rest of his trip a bit more comfortable.
But as they hit the open road, the weather closes in.
Visibility's down to probably 50 metres or less. We have to slow down in the fog, it's just no option. Because I need to keep an eye on that crate, make sure everything's intact.
Rather than risk the conditions, it's time for a break.
So we're just going to pull in here and have a bit of a spell. Go and have a look at our patient. Hey, dude. Hey, mate. Seems pretty happy, doesn't he?
A few hours later, the fog lifts. Along with Mick's mood.
I'm feeling a lot more relaxed this morning. It's been an eventful trip, and we're not finished just yet, because we're only just over halfway.
Outside the town of Berry, power company workers arrive to clear the path ahead.
I'm concerned about the time. We're getting held up a bit.
The permit for this job only allows Mick to drive until 8 a.m. After that, he could be grounded for the rest of the day. Not good for Mtundu's stress levels.
Really only got an hour and 10 minutes to get off the road. So I'm thinking at the moment we're going to blow out, so I didn't need this at all.
And Mtundu's losing his patience too.
Our mate's moving around in the back at the moment. I can feel the truck moving. I think he's getting anxious too.
With the wires finally cleared, Mick's desperate to make the 8 a.m. deadline.
Righto, Pop, we'll see if we can make up a bit of time, mate. We got to keep pushing on, bud.
Yep.
But this fragile road needs a smooth ride.
These windy roads are slowing us up again. We're trying to make up some time, but we're not doing that well. I don't want to turn too sharp or anything to upset our passenger. So it's just, it is what it is. I'm hoping we don't get nailed. There it is, that's 8 o'clock.
Time's up. But taking an exhausted giraffe off the road for 24 hours while Mick tries to get another permit isn't an option.
We're officially running hot.
He needs to buy some time from the traffic police.
Angus, Mick, mate.
How you going?
We're going to be, I don't know, maybe half an hour late or something.
I'll stop the northbound traffic, mate, so you get a run through.
Okay, thank you very much, mate. Bye-bye, Angus. That's for a good cause. A little bit of leniency. Who's going to pull over a giraffe?
But 3 days at sea and 5 hours on the road have taken their toll. Mtundu has dropped out of sight.
I don't know what's going on here.
The zookeepers make an emergency stop.
He's hadn't seen him for the last 15 minutes.
Are we right?
He's just sitting down, but he's knackered like he is.
Is he?
Yeah.
Exhausted, but okay for the time being.
Sorry about that.
No, that's all right. it's all good.
He's been really sleepy, and then he just went down. He's sort of bobbing, but we'll just get there now. He's exhausted.
Mtundu may be tired, but lying down for too long is dangerous. It can send too much blood to the brain, causing a giraffe to faint and choke.
Hopefully he's going to stick it out to the end of the journey. I think everyone's going to be happy to close this job off, I think, including myself.
Up ahead, a narrow bridge, which could mean more delays.
We should see quite a few people on Batemans Bay Bridge.
They're in luck. Police have stopped traffic.
All good, mate.
Thanks, mate. Thank you.
After 6 hours on the road, a welcome sight.
We've made it.
It's almost over.
But has Mtundu made it? It's been an exhausting 2,500-kilometer journey, but finally, his first steps on Australian soil. Home sweet home.
He's up now, he's all right.
For Mick, it's all been worth it.
You're a chip. You thank you very much for the kid.
Absolute pleasure.